Hello, everybody. How are you? We are now live on Facebook, and I want to welcome everybody here that's on Zoom with us today. We have a really nice, large audience for our incredible guests that we have today. Ryan, I'm really excited that you're here.
I am so excited to be here with you, Vija. Thank you so much for having me. It's a real pleasure to join you.
Yeah, thanks for being here. So my name is Vija Williams. I'm with the Ben Kinney Companies, and we do these real estate agent training webinars every single Wednesday, almost without fail, at noon Pacific Standard Time. What these are highly tactical and actionable webinars, and they are hands-on training. Our goal in these trainings is that you walk away from one to three things you can do within an hour of every webinar. And that's really what we try to do. These are free. These are open to everybody. These are our way of giving back, right? We have people all over the world that attend these from all different brokerages, and everybody's welcome. So today I'm really excited to do something a little different. I think that a lot of us, you know, you can Google, you can get on YouTube, you can get on Google, and you can search listing presentation. And there's a lot of gurus, I say with quotes, with air quotes, who will train you on that. I mean, everybody's a teacher. Everybody's a listing presentation teacher. And what I wanted to do today, and what I'm going to actually do periodically throughout the year, is I wanted to get masters to actually role play a listing presentation as if nobody was watching. In fact, to the point where Ryan and I have agreed to not even look at the chat window. We've agreed to just pretend that we're on a Zoom together, and we're not even going to look at questions or get on Facebook and look at the comments until afterwards, because we just want to be in the moment and just kind of get into a really, you know, just normal role play, just like you were eavesdropping on an appointment. We're going to do this, like I said, throughout the year. We're going to do some buyer consults and some other listing presentations. I'm going to try to get a luxury agent to do this for us, and, you know, all sorts of different iterations of this. I handpicked Ryan to do the first one with me because, first of all, Ryan Greigg is a great guy. And if you don't know Ryan, he's incredible. Give any referrals for Bellingham, Washington, I highly recommend him. Ryan's got a really cool background, and Ryan, feel free to jump in on this. He comes from the music industry. He was an international touring disc jockey, DJ. We used to call him disc jockeys, Ryan, I'm old. But DJ, you were a DJ. And then you were an artist developer and like tour manager, I think, right? And you were the guy that was in those nightclubs, right, with like thousands of people, weren't you?
I was for a long time. I was a disc jockey, and I can actually say that, Via, because I started collecting records. So I go back to the DJ time where we played actual records. Yeah, 7-inch and 45s. And I did that for a little over 10 years. And I also did artist and tour management, bringing artists from around the world and then going on tour with those artists. And I actually completed my real estate school and license while on tour, a 3-week long tour up and down the West Coast was when I finished real estate school.
Did you have a professional name that you went by or moniker?
I do. I started a group of DJs called Blessed Coast Sound, like West Coast, but Blessed Coast. And there are three of us in that group of DJs. The other two are much more active still. I'm not. It's more just a hobby for me now. And the DJ name that was given to me almost 20 years ago was just DJ Ryan I, the letter I. And there's a long story that goes with that I'll save for another time. But DJing was my previous career. And then Vija, you've met my son, Bentley. He'll turn 9 tomorrow. And it was just, you know, when he was born, it was like this traveling all over and staying out late, it's not going to work anymore. And that's what caused the change.
I'm always drawn to music people. It wasn't a surprise when I just started clicking with you. And of course, I knew that you were a music guy. My son's a music performance major. My dad was a music performance major. It's just music is my, you know, so I think that's a cool background. So you went into real estate, Ryan. And I think what's cool too is you just came in first year and you not only got rookie of the year in your office, you got rookie of the year for the entire Whatcom County. You did about 10 million and 45 homes sold your first year. I don't see that a lot. That's pretty impressive. And then kind of leading up to where we are now, last year in 2020, you became the co-leader of the Ben Kinney team in Bellingham, right? And you sold, I'm going to look this up, 25 million last year, 58 transactions, 30 of which were listings during COVID. Very, very impressive. Your team took 186 listings last year using the listing presentation that we're about to see in Whatcom County, which for all of you guys outside of Washington State is in northern Washington. So it's almost on the Canadian border. If you think of Vancouver, Canada, Bellingham is just south of that. So this is kind of that whole area if you're looking on a map. And Bentley, you are completely devoted to your son, Bentley, or Ryan, you are completely devoted to your son, Bentley, because you bring him to events. I think it's really been cool to watch you. And you have a brand new wife named Vasha, which, you know, that's like really new. In fact, that's why we had to reschedule this, because you had your honeymoon, right?
Funny you said that. I actually didn't have my honeymoon.
Oh.
I was set to go on that. And well, I got COVID.
Oh, perfect.
And perfect. So that's another long story that we can save for another time. Oh. But 2 days before I was supposed to go on my honeymoon, I tested positive for COVID, oddly enough. And it was, thankfully, I had very little symptoms, actually almost no symptoms. And most people didn't even know I had it because I didn't miss a day at work. I didn't miss anything. I worked from home because I had to.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
So we didn't go on that honeymoon. But we are married and we will go on that honeymoon. And so, yes, I absolutely love my wife and my son. And that's why I do what I do.
I'm really sorry to hear that. And I'm really glad to hear that you're healthy right now. Thank you for hanging in there.
Okay. You know, that's another whole other story for another time. I think it just taught me that I can get through anything. And I had been training really hard physically. And I'm so thankful that I had, because I got sick and it just didn't affect me very much.
Yeah. Wow. All right. Okay, Ryan, we're going to jump in. So what you and I decided, we met before this and we kind of came up with a game plan. So what you and I decided that I'm really excited about is we're going to actually start with this with the phone call. We're going to work under the assumption that I'm a referral, and we're going to start kind of, you know, so everyone gets a feel for how you set up the appointment and what kind of pre-qualification you do. And you're going to close that with a Zoom meeting. And so we're going to do a Zoom listing presentation, and then we're going to go right into the role play. Are you ready?
I am ready, Vija. Let's do it.
All right, let's do it. Ring, ring, ring.
Hello, this is Ryan.
Hi, Ryan. This is Vija Williams, and I'm thinking about selling my home. Not sure, but I think that we're going to probably do it. And I was referred to you by our mutual friend, Jolene, and she said you were great and just kind of wanted to follow up with that and see what the next steps would be.
Oh my gosh, Vija, that's great. Thank you so much for the call. I really appreciate you reaching out to me, and I'll definitely make sure to reach out. And I didn't catch the name of the friend. What was the name?
Jolene Snell.
Jolene, got it. I know Jolene. Gosh, I got to make sure to reach out to Jolene and thank her so much. I'm really honored that she referred you to us and our team to help you get your property sold. I loved working with Jolene. We've helped her actually a couple times. And I'd love to hear more about you, Vija. So it sounds like you have a home that you're considering selling. I'm going to grab a piece of paper and some notepads here. Tell me a little bit more about your home, Vija, and what's on your mind. I'd love to hear. I'm just going to be taking notes.
Yeah, well, the address is 12345 State Street. We're in Kirkland, and it's a 1988 home that we've remodeled. And we, you know, we're thinking of upgrading. We're not sure. We know, you know, it's one of the things I want to talk to you about. I'm not too worried about selling, Ryan. I'll tell you right now, we're a little worried about buying. So we can talk about that later. But, you know, just kind of want to find out what market value would be, kind of what the process would look like, and if we need to do anything to get the house prepared, you know, and we'll probably move forward. I think we're feeling like we want to do this.
That sounds great, Vija. So just to make sure I heard you right there, it sounds like you got your home here at 12345 State Street in Kirkland. It was built in 88, and you've done some updates on it, and it sounds like you're pretty set on selling, but it also sounds like maybe you're not quite sure on where you're going to go. Did I hear you right on that?
Yeah, and I should say we would love to sell because we would love to buy. So I think my caution comes from the fact that I'm concerned about the purchase.
You know, I hear that a lot lately, Vija. I hear that a lot of folks want to sell their home for one reason or another, and it's actually not selling the home that they're worried about. It's buying a home and where they're going to go. I'm curious, Vija, when you sell this home and when we help you get this home sold, will you be staying here in Kirkland, or are you going to move somewhere out of the area?
We really would. What we had in mind was, you know, a newer, more modern home in Kirkland, you know, and in our kind of general same area, actually, just upgrading home.
Okay. So it sounds like you like the area that you live in, mm-hmm. but just a newer home and more modern home is what you guys are looking for. Did I hear that right?
Yeah.
Okay. Is the size of your current home suitable for what you're looking for? Do you need more space? Do you need more property or anything like that as well?
You know, it's not only suitable, it might even be too big. You know, we'd even be open to a little smaller.
Okay. So if I'm hearing you right, V, it sounds like the reason that you guys might be wanting to sell your home is simply to buy another home here in the area. You sounds like you like your neighborhood. It's a great neighborhood. I can see why you'd want to stay there. And it sounds like finding something that's a little bit more modern and some nicer finishes perhaps, and even a little bit smaller, downsizing, it sounds like. Am I hearing you all right there?
Yeah. Yep.
Perfect. Okay. Well, Vija, I would love the opportunity to show you some of the homes that are available that fit what you're looking for right now. In fact, I met with a seller just the other day. This home's not on the market yet. It might actually be a really good fit for you. You know, I'm meeting with a seller or two every day, and I'm seeing homes that aren't quite ready to hit the market yet. I would love to see if I can play matchmaker with you, and maybe we can find a home before it even hits the market. It sounds like that's your biggest concern, would be making sure you have a home to go to before you sell your home. Is that the biggest concern with selling your current home, Vija?
Well, yeah. Can I ask you a question about that?
Please.
I'm curious. So are you meeting with this person about maybe listing their house?
You know, the cool thing about that, Vija, is I meet with, like I said, a seller or two every day. And what that's doing is these people are going to a list that we call our would sell list, people that would sell that just aren't ready yet to put their home on the market for one reason or the other. A lot of times that home ends up hitting the market, but sometimes it never hits the market because they're like you and they can't find what they're looking for. The good thing about it is I'm constantly playing matchmaker with folks like yourself and folks like them that have a home that they want to sell but don't know where they're going to go. So that home might get listed, but maybe it won't, especially if you're the right buyer for it. I'd love to take you over there before it gets listed. Would you like that if we could get you in there before it got listed?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Perfect. Well, I'll tell you what, Vija, why don't we set up a time where we can get together and we can talk more about that. I'd love to actually meet with you, get to know you in person and anybody else that might be involved in this decision-making process and really find out more about the home that you guys are looking for. And while I'm over there, I can take a tour of your home. We can tour your home. I can give you an idea of what your home can sell for in today's market. And then we can talk about next steps and coming up with a plan to get your home sold and finding the next home at the same time. Does that sound roughly what you're looking to do, Vija?
Oh, perfect, yeah.
Okay, perfect. A lot of times folks are having me come out of their home and tour their home, but I know you're really busy in it. And Jalene mentioned that maybe doing a Zoom meeting might be more beneficial for you. I'd be happy to walk through the home with you virtually over a Zoom call and also go through our listing presentation and show you what we're doing to get homes like yours sold over a Zoom call. Would that be better than maybe meeting in person via to do an online meeting sometime in the next day or two?
That would be awesome, actually. Thanks for offering that. I would prefer Zoom.
Absolutely. I'm looking at my calendar and it looks like I've got some availabilities as soon as either tomorrow evening or the following morning. What's better for you, Vija? Are mornings or evenings better?
Could you do tonight? Could you pop by tonight or do the Zoom tonight?
Let me check. It looks like I've got a couple appointments from 5 until 6 and then 6 until 7. I'd be happy to meet with you about 7:15 right after that last appointment. Would that time work for you?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Perfect. Okay. So Vija, are you familiar with how Zoom works and using
yeah.
Zoom for calls like this?
Yeah, I feel super comfortable with Zoom, so.
Great, so what I'm gonna do, as soon as we hop off the call, I'll go ahead and send you a calendar invitation for our Zoom meeting for tonight.
Oh, no, wait, I don't know Zoom very well. I don't know Zoom very well.
You don't know, okay. Are there any other online FaceTime type of platforms that you do know well that you prefer to use?
Oh, well, I could do FaceTime, sure. Well, let's do Zoom. My husband, we can do Zoom. It's okay.
So, tangent, if they can't do Zoom, they can't do something where I can share a screen. I'll do whatever they can do.
Okay.
I'll take a FaceTime meeting, right? So, well, that sounds great, Vija. We will plan to meet on Zoom, and I'm going to send you a calendar invitation. It looks like the email that I got was via@benkinneyteam.com. Is that the best email to send that to?
It's actually via@benkinney.com.
Thank you for clarifying that for me. I'll go ahead and send that over to you. And then I look forward to meeting with you at 7:15. Just a couple more questions before I let you go, Vija. Do you have a couple more minutes so I can get some more information about your home specifically?
Yeah, you bet.
And guys, if you aren't familiar, I have what's called the yellow sheet, our seller sheet. This is famous in the Ben Kinney and Place world. And this will allow me to get all the information from Vija that I'm going to need to know prior to going into that appointment. So I've already asked some of these questions, and I would say something like this. Vija, I'm actually going to read some of these questions off to you. It's a pretty thorough sheet, and I just want to make sure I don't miss anything. Would that be okay?
Sure.
Perfect. So I've got your address. I've got that. I've got where you're moving to. It sounds like if we could find a home that fits what you're looking for, you'd be ready to list immediately. Is that right?
As long as my house is ready, I think I need your guys on a little bit. Yes, mentally, we could list immediately, but I'm not sure the house is ready.
Got it. We'd be happy to help go over the things that can get your home ready to be ready for market. Vija, how long have you owned your home?
2.5 years.
And we're going to breeze through these quick for time's sake. What do you owe on the property?
$100,000.
Great. Vija, I'm curious, have you sold a home before, or is this your first time selling a home?
Yeah, we've sold a couple homes before. Yeah.
Okay, great. When was the last time you sold a home?
About 2.5 years ago when we bought this one.
Makes sense. Are you the only person on title, Vija, or will there be other people on title making decisions as well?
Yeah, it'll be my husband and I, and he'll be joining us at our appointments.
Great. What's your husband's name, Vija?
It's Ben.
Ben, perfect. I actually looked up the home really quick online, and like you mentioned, it had some nice updates. I'm just curious, have you done any additional updates, Vija, that I might not know about by looking at the home online from when you bought it a couple years ago?
Yeah, actually, the pictures, if you're looking at the last listing, it's been completely renovated since then. The last listing showed it. It basically was in its original state when we purchased it, and we've completely renovated it.
I'm so glad I asked that. You know, a lot of agents, sometimes they show up at the house and they've done this market analysis for a home that actually isn't even the right home because the seller had done all these updates to it. I'm glad I asked you that. It sounds like I've gotten most of the information that I need. You've done some updates and some major updates, it sounds like. Vija, I'm curious, do you know how much homes like yours are selling for in neighborhoods like yours?
In my neighborhood, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I think so. I think where I'm confused with mine is my neighborhood has like a whole bunch of new big homes and it doesn't have a lot of older homes like mine. And so that's confusing a little bit to me.
I could see that. I could see how that would be confusing. And that's something we'll certainly go over when we meet virtually and then in person after we take the next steps of me coming to take a tour of the home. Just a couple more questions, Vija, and I'll let you go. I know Jalene had referred you to us. And Jalene has actually bought and sold a few properties with us and referred us, I think, 6 or 7 other people now. I love working with people like Jalene and her friends. And she has expressed that she really likes the fact that I communicate regularly with her. I'm curious, Vija, what are the 3 things that you're looking for in a real estate team?
Probably, a referral, it means a lot that when Jalene says you're the best, that carries a lot of weight with me. And I think responsiveness, I like working with really quick people that get back to me quickly. I'm a big texter. I don't need a lot of phone conversations, but I like quick responses. And just someone who's not shy giving their opinions and their advice, you know, not guarded. I just would prefer unfiltered, tell me how it is.
I love that. You know, Vija, I'm the exact same way. I'm kind of a call it as I see it type of guy. So it sounds like you and I could really be honest with each other. Is that right?
For sure. That's the way I prefer.
Great. Okay. And I'm really glad that you mentioned that also, Vija, because I always ask people when they say they like to communicate, I like to know their preferred style of communication, whether it's a phone call or a text, or sometimes people only want an email. It sounds like text message is the best way you like to be communicated with.
It really is the best for me. Yeah.
If I've got some really good news for you, Vija, like when we put your home on the market and when we get an offer that's really strong, would it be okay if I called you?
Yeah, for sure. You know, if we kind of establish that rule up front, I'll assume if I see a call from you, it's important.
Perfect. Okay. I won't call you unless it's urgent. I'll use text as our main forms of communication. Vija, I think that's all I need for now. I'll probably have a couple more questions, but we can go over those when we meet at 7:15. I'll go ahead and send that email over to you. And I'm really looking forward to meeting with you and Ben virtually on our Zoom meeting. And I'll see you then, Vija.
Sounds good. All right.
Cool. Okay. And we're just going to jump right into that Zoom meeting, right?
Yeah. 7:15, Ryan. Come on. I'm on time.
All right. Let's jump in. Well, Vija, I'm so thankful that we actually get to meet face-to-face now. And I know it's a little bit different than maybe a face-to-face meeting was in the past. But I really wanted to just take a moment and thank you and Ben for spending some time to meet with me and my team, and so that we can find out what's really important to you and how we can help you achieve your real estate goals. But before I do that, Vija, I just wanted to take a quick moment and congratulate you because Jalene told me you have this really cool podcast. And she said you recently had this milestone of having 100,000 downloads on it. And
you are the best.
How you have this cool investment property and your son just moved into it. And so I'm just sugar lumping Vija right now, right? And I'm
totally working. I'm literally signing right now.
Before we even start, I'm just trying to build rapport. And I did a little research on Vija, right? I looked her up online. I looked up her Facebook page. I found out what I could so that I could have a more important conversation, more relevant conversation. So anyways, Vija, congratulations. That is so cool. I do a podcast about, right? Before we get started on my listing presentation and what we're going to do to help you get your home sold, Vija, were there any questions that came up between the last time we spoke and now that you'd like me to address first?
No, I might have questions after, but you know, not at this point yet.
Perfect.
Just curious for what you have to say, you know, so.
Absolutely. Well, I'm going to go ahead and launch into what's called our seller's experience. And I absolutely love this, Vija. I could talk about this all day and I might even get excited and really get going fast, but I want you to know if I say something that doesn't make sense to you, or you're not quite sure about how I said something, will you just let me know and stop me even and make sure that I can clarify that before I move on? And maybe even take a couple notes and at the end we can go over anything that you wanted me to clarify. But if I say something that doesn't make sense, just stop me and let me know so I can clarify that for you, okay?
You bet.
Perfect. I'm gonna go ahead and share my screen now. What that's gonna do is allow me to bring up our seller experience packet. Let me just make sure that this works, Vija. Now, can you see? You can see my screen on there, right? Okay, perfect. I'm gonna go ahead and launch into what's called our seller experience guide. And I absolutely love this. I'm really passionate about the way our team helps people with their real estate needs. And like you see here, the first page, Vija, we're powered by Place. And Jalene may have told you, but we have created and launched this amazing organization that we launched about a year ago with our team, the Ben Kinney team, and a really amazing individual from Oregon named Chris Suarez with Experience Real Estate.
I've definitely heard of Chris Suarez, but not this Ben Kinney guy.
Oh my gosh, I'm glad you brought that up, Vija, because let me just jump right in. And the first page on here, I'll go back to that one. This right here will go into who Ben and Chris are. And you know, sometimes I got to read this, Vija, because this is so powerful. And it's going to tell you a little bit about Ben and a little bit about Chris. But I want to thank you for choosing our company for here at Place to just have the opportunity to meet with you, Vija. And we're a private exclusive network made up of the top real estate professionals from a variety of brands and brokerages across the world. You see, Vija, we empower our agents with leading technology, marketing, and support solutions to ensure that your home will sell for the most amount of money in the least amount of time, but not before we find you that home that you want to move into. See, Vija, our mission is simple. It's to deliver the dream of home ownership everywhere. And we continue to be dedicated to making that reality for thousands of families worldwide, which I'm going to go into detail in just a little bit. I'd like to go back to the previous page before we carry on. And you can see down below, Ben and Chris, the co-founders of Place, and my mentors. And these are the folks that I've learned from. And as I'll get into as part of our team, Ben is actually still going to be your co-listing agent. And I'll tell you more about that when we talk about our team.
So will he be coming to my home or?
That's a good question, Vija. He actually won't need to come to your home. I'll be your point of contact. I'll be the one that comes to your home along with my team of assistants. So Ben will be there for a co-listing. And what that will do will allow his lag number, which is his number on the MLS, to have your listing added to the thousands of other listings that we have on the market so people can see that you're represented by the top team in the nation.
Okay.
In addition to that, the reason that Ben will be a co-listing agent on there, and it's so important, and we'll talk about this when we talk about our team, is that's gonna allow us to have much more strength when we market your property and how we negotiate the deal. And I'll go into much more detail as we carry on. But I just wanted to talk about this, Vija, because over the next 15 or 20 minutes, I might be talking a lot about myself and my team and what we're gonna do, but I wanna make sure you know this, that really this experience is all about you. It's all about your needs, your dreams, your questions, your timeline, and ultimately finding your place, Vija. And we're gonna make sure that we understand those unique lifestyle needs, wishes, and specific goals so that we can get you where you wanna go. Okay.
Can I do an aside? Have we done a walkthrough yet?
We haven't done a walkthrough yet.
Okay, keep going, sorry.
So we haven't done a walkthrough yet. And side note, we haven't done a walkthrough yet, Vija, because I'm on a Zoom call. I'm going to go right into the listing presentation with folks, and then we're going to do the walkthrough.
Oh, thanks for clarifying. Okay.
Yep. And we're going to, and I should have clarified that with you previously. I should have clarified that on the previous call that we're going to do this first and then we'll do the walkthrough, right?
Right.
So Vija, the first thing that I would love to talk with you about is the four things that's going to set our company apart compared to any other small real estate team or an individual agent. And I'll go into each one of these in detail after. But first, I wanted to touch down on each one of them. The first, Vija, is the fact that we work as a team. Like I mentioned, you get Ben Kinney, the number one sales team in the entire state of Washington, as your co-listing agent with me. And the reason for having a team, Vija, is because we know there's 180 different tasks required to properly sell your property. And when you hire us, you get a team of specialists to make sure and tackle all those tasks. And it's all for the same price as hiring an individual agent or a small team. Pretty cool, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, Vija, the second thing that's going to set us apart is our track record. And simply put, we consistently sell the most properties for the most amount of money based on places like the Wall Street Journal, top agents and top teams in America. And I'll jump into how many homes our team sold last year nationwide and specifically here in the area. And the third thing that sets us apart, Vija, is going to be what we call our transparency and really how we communicate with you, with other agents, and with the buyers that come through your home. The cool thing that we've done, Vija, is we now offer 24-hour access for you to see everything that we're doing to ensure your property sells fast and for the most amount of money. And then the last thing that's gonna set us apart, Vija, is the way we're gonna market your property. You see, simply nobody is gonna do more to market your property online, offline, and internationally than Place will. And
I'm interested in that. Are you gonna kind of go into that, Ryan? You're gonna show me how you're gonna market my property today?
Absolutely, Vija. And great. I would love to spend actually the most time in what's most important to you. I'm curious, before I continue, which of these things, these four items, would be the most important to you, Vija?
The marketing, I think. I think I trust you on the first three things. You came highly recommended, and I am curious about marketing, especially like international. I'm hearing a lot of things about people relocating here from the Bay Area, international and stuff. So I'm curious about that.
Okay. We can do one of two things, Vija. It sounds like you're pretty confident in the fact that we work as a team and you understand that. It sounds like you understand our track record and our transparency. I can either continue to go into more detail on these, or I can specifically focus just on the marketing piece of our listing presentation. Which would you prefer? And just go ahead and do me a favor and say you'd rather me go into detail on each of them.
I would rather you go into detail on each of them.
But if the seller says, well, no, just tell me about marketing, I'm going to shift this a little bit and go right into marketing. And then I will go back into these and cover them to make sure they know what they're going to do.
That's perfect.
Sounds like you'd like me to go into each one of these, Vija, and let me go ahead and do that. So let's start with the fact that we work as a team. Like I mentioned, when you list your property with our company, you get myself and Ben as your co-listing agent. And I'm so glad that you asked if Ben would be coming, because I get that question all the time. Who will I be communicating with? I will be your contact person. Any questions you might have, they can go right to me. And I know you prefer to communicate via text. So you can text me anytime, Vija. 7 days a week from 8 a.m. till 8 p.m. I'm available, and you have my permission to text me anytime.
And could I text Ben too? Do you think he'd get back to me?
You could absolutely text Ben as well. Yeah, in fact, because you were a referral from us, I'll go ahead and let Ben know. And I just closed on a deal with Ben actually 2 months ago. Ben and I went out, showed buyers properties, and closed, and we were in a group message with Ben. So yes, absolutely. So Vija, the reason that you need to know about our team is that moving your home from contract to close, like I said earlier, is going to require a minimum of 180 different tasks. And we know that no single agent can effectively manage that. They might be able to when they have no listings or one listing, but really our team of professionals is going to work collaboratively and across all the different positions. And so that I can give 100% of my attention, Vija, to be with you, to get your home ready for the market. And when we get the offers, to negotiate those deals to get you the most amount of money. That is my number one role in this transaction. Does that make sense to you, Vija?
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. And this shows here at the bottom some of the other members of our team, like our marketing manager, our contract coordinator, our telemarketers, my buyers team. I mentioned to you, Ryan Randall, my buyer specialist that I work with. When you guys go out and start looking at homes, he'll be the one that shows you those homes. And of course, our visual specialists that will come take photos and make sure your home is really going to shine when it hits the market. Vija, I'm curious, does everything that I mentioned about how we work as a team make sense, or did you have any questions on that?
Oh, it's really impressive. Thank you.
Great. And I would throw in a trial close here. Vija, before I carry on, has any other agent mentioned anything about how they work as a team, or did I go ahead and clarify all that for you?
Yeah, it's weird because I haven't had any agents meet with us. We've met with two, but that are a team. The only agents I've had come meet are just, they just work on their own. So I was curious if I was going to actually get to work with you, or if I was just going to get transferred over to your assistant or your team. And what I think I understand is it's you. I get to talk to you the whole time. I get to call you, text you. And even though you have this team, that you're my contact, is that right?
Absolutely. And I'm really glad that you asked that and that we could clarify that for you, because that comes up a lot. And I really like to make sure that people understand I will be your direct point of contact. You can call me and text message me anytime, and I will be the one that will be communicating with you. Now, the cool thing is, Vija, in addition to me communicating with you regularly, you're going to hear from my team as well. You'll hear from my admin staff. You'll hear from the folks over at Brivity, which I'll go into more detail, which is the software that we've created to allow you to have that transparency of logging in, see all of the items that we're completing to make sure your home sells. So while I'll be your main point of contact, you'll get a couple of emails from my admin staff, and you'll get a call or two from my assistant when there's some paperwork coming your way, but I'll be your point of contact and you can reach out to me at any time. Did I answer all that for you okay?
Yeah, that's great.
Perfect. Okay, let's jump into the second thing that sets us apart, Vija. And this one, you know, it can sound like a lot to some folks, so I like to make sure that I'm putting it into perspective. Like I mentioned, Vija, our track record is the second thing that sets us apart. And according to the Wall Street Journal top agents, there's nobody that's selling more homes than our team is across the nation. And this number sounds like a lot. Our team sold over 6,000 homes last year. We spent over $10 million on marketing our listings. And of all those sales, Vija, the great thing was that we got a 4.9 out of 5 star of hundreds and hundreds of reviews. Now, yeah, I told you in the start that number might sound like a lot. It might sound like a little if we don't have any perspective. But like it says here, Vija, what we do know is the average agent, and this is according to the National Association of Realtors, the average agent, Vija, with a decade of experience is selling about 12 properties a year. Our team sold about 6,000 nationwide last year, and I specifically sold about 60 of those right here in your neighborhood. The reason I'm telling you that, Vija, is because that allows us to have more money to market your property. That allows us to have more experience negotiating the deal. Does that make sense on how having an effective track record is going to be super important in making sure you get your home sold?
It does, yeah.
Perfect. Now, the third thing that's going to set us apart, Vija, is what we call our transparency. And I absolutely love this because this was one of the number one problems in real estate that a lot of realtors had complaints about, was my agent would put my home on the market and I never knew what they were doing after that. I never knew what they were doing to earn that commission. So what we've done is we've created a software program called Brivity, where you get 24-hour access to your client portal, and that's gonna show you all the tasks that we've completed, and you're gonna be amazed to see every single day, every single task that myself, my admin staff, and my virtual assistants are completing to make sure that your home is getting the most amount of money in the least amount of time. It's phenomenal. Now, one question that comes up, Vija, is do I just rely on that for the feedback, or will you and I be communicating as well? You and I will become best friends as soon as your home hits the market, Vija, because I'm gonna be communicating with you daily, because as you know, this market is active. And there's a good chance when we put your home on the market, you might get 10, 20, 40 showings in the first 24 hours. So you're going to be hearing from me a lot. So this is a backup plan to make sure you see everything that goes on, but that's not the only way that you're going to hear the feedback. You're going to hear from every single showing feedback directly from me as well. Okay. That all make sense, Vija?
Yeah.
Cool. And the last thing that's going to set us apart, that I'm going to really dive into detail here for you, Vija, because I know this is the most important thing with you, is how we're going to market your property. Like I said earlier, no one's going to do more to market it online, offline, internationally. And like you said, international buyers are coming from all over the world. It's incredibly important to have a real estate team that's going to make sure to have your property showcased on all international portals. again, I'll put this into perspective for you, Via. Last year, we had over a million potential buyers visiting our network of websites. And to compare that to an average agent, they spent about $70 last year on their website, if they even had one, because they lacked the resources to make their websites rank high. And oftentimes, nobody even sees them online. When you compare that with traditional marketing, the amount of money that was spent, we spent over $10 million last year to market our properties. And the crazy thing when you compare that, Via, is an average agent spent $520 last year to market their properties. And that wasn't just one property. That wasn't for just 1 month. That was the whole year. And the last thing, Via, is making sure that your property is seen internationally, because we know that over a quarter million buyers visited just one of our websites last year from other countries around the world. Okay, Via, this page is something that we've recently added, and I absolutely love it because not a lot of agents are going to talk about this. Before I get into this, did you have any questions about the four things that set us apart, Via?
No.
Perfect. Now, I love this page because it's going to go into detail how we're going to market your property to the three types of buyers. And Via, I know you and I spoke a little bit about music, so I imagine both you and I are probably somewhat of auditory buyers, but you might know that there's also other types of buyers, and there's visual buyers or kinesthetic buyers. And our goal is to make sure we're catering to each one of those, Via. And I could go into detail about those. I'm sure you understand that, but the goal is to make sure that the auditory ones are going to hear what we have to say. The visual ones are going to see it. And those kinesthetic ones, we got to get those folks in your house so they can touch the texture of the wall, they can feel the countertops. And our goal is to make sure not just to market to one of these, but make sure we're hitting all three. Pretty cool, right?
Yeah, I'm curious how you market to auditory buyers.
That's a great question, Via. There's a lot of different ways that we're marketing to auditory buyers. One way would be just like what we're doing right now and hopping on a call with them and walking them through that home and making sure that we're communicating with them. So I could send you an email with a link to a property. However, for an auditory buyer, they want me to be face-to-face with them, telling them what's going on in that home, saying, what's behind that door there? Can you show me that over there? How does that look over there? Can you hear the freeway? Can you jump up and down on the floor there and have somebody stand down below? Because I want to know if I can hear. So something along those lines. Does that answer your question, Via?
Thank you.
Okay. We've covered the four things that set us apart as a team, Via. So the next thing I'd like to get into is the eight things that will make your home sell. And I'd like to speed up the pace a little bit for time's sake, because I want to make sure that we get some questions answered at the end. So I'm going to dive into this. But Via, we know that ultimately there's going to be eight things that really make your home sell. And not only sell, but for the most amount of money in the least amount of time. Number one is going to be how it's priced. Number two is going to be how it shows. Number three is how it's marketed. Number four is how it's marketed internationally. Number five is how we're going to communicate with you, the agents that are going to bring the buyers and the buyers coming through. Number six is having an active buyer database. Number seven is our partnerships. And number eight is our negotiations. And I'd like to go into each one of these in a little bit more detail, if that's okay with you, Via. And then I promise I'm going to dive into that marketing piece that I know you're waiting patiently for. So first off, Via, the number one factor, of course, in selling a property is how well it's priced. And our real estate team uses the most accurate method available to price your property. And in fact, it's the exact same method that the appraiser is going to use or an investor is going to use. And we call it the 5-5-5 pricing strategy. And after this call, Via, we're going to take a tour of your home. And the next step would be for me to come tour your home in person when we can. And I'm going to take note of all the unique features. And then I'm going to do my best to take your home. And I'm going to compare that home to five active properties, five pending properties, meaning the offer has been accepted, but it hasn't closed yet, and five sold properties. I'm going to take all that data and I'm going to then sit down with you and we're going to review that data. And you and I together, Via, are going to come up with the price we feel your home will sell at. Make sense?
Yeah. So are we going to go over price tonight?
Absolutely. Okay. We can absolutely go over price tonight. If you'd like, we could even go over it right now, but I think we'll continue on with this and then we'll circle back to that if that's okay with you.
Sounds great.
The second thing, Vija, is how well your home shows. So price is important, but also how well it shows is going to be important. See, Vija, today's buyers are armed with more information than ever. They're telling their agents which homes they want to see. You know, a decade ago, we would sit down with buyers and they would come in and say, here's a list of properties that we're going to show you. Now those buyers come in and they have that list and they tell us the properties they want to see. So we need to make sure that when your home hits the market, it hits with an impact. And those buyers then come in and say, Ryan, these are the homes that I want to see. And yours should be number one on that list because it shows so well. The third thing, Vija, is how your home is marketed and also how it's marketed internationally. And I can jump into this. In fact, let me go ahead and jump into this now because I know the marketing part is super important to you. See, Vija, we spend a lot of time annually reviewing all of the data from the National Association of Realtors and their profiles to make sure that we're getting the most accurate information and looking at all the actual properties of where buyers found their properties. And you see down below, we know that, and I'm sure you understand that most buyers, in fact, half are going to see their home online. That's where they're going to hear about it. But we also know that despite what some companies and folks might be saying, that having a realtor is incredibly important these days, both for selling your home and also finding your home, because almost a third of people actually found their home through having a realtor. And, you know, about 22% of people, they found their home through that old traditional marketing, like a yard sign they maybe saw or a friend or a relative or maybe seeing it in some print ads. Now, Vija, it's going to be ultra important that not only are we marketing your property online, but that we're spending some extra time to market your property to the top agents in town, because we know that realistically 20% of the agents, Vija, are doing 80% of all the business in town. And that's why it's really important that I stay active in my real estate community by participating with local meetings, by having an active presence on social media and sharing your listing with top agents as soon as it hits the market. And there's gonna be 5 ways that we make sure that all agents know about your home. We're gonna send them electronic flyers. We're reaching out to all the brokerages. We're sending them the virtual tours and we're communicating with them regularly. And we're even gonna drop that note card off at their office with the print media. Now, one of the things that I absolutely love about our team and that if you were to come into my office, I think you'd be really blown away by is our internet marketing and technical team. And below, you'll see some of those individuals like our director of user experience and design, our director of agent communities and SEO blogging expert, our VP of digital advertising products, and our chief technical officer. Now, Vija, one of the reasons this is so amazing is because all of this is in-house. All of this is under our one umbrella. And simply put, we're a technology company and we know how to reach the 97% of buyers that are looking online. And we're going to make sure that when they see your property online, we're able to reach them immediately through our buyers data, or through our active buyer database and through our telemarketers. Now, I'd like to spend a little bit of time, Vija, of specifically how we're going to market your property online, because we know everybody's looking online. Are you looking online for homes when you're looking to buy one?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Do you have a favorite place, Vija, that you like to look online?
I'm kind of on Zillow or Redfin.
Perfect. Vija, there's going to be 5 places that we market your property online. The first is brokerage websites. Now, this is a question that I get pretty often that, Ryan, if I list with you, with your brokerage with Keller Williams, will Remax agents see it? Will Compass agents see it? And absolutely yes, Vija. As soon as you list with us, your property will be syndicated to all brokerage websites. The second place where your property is going to be showcased is on all listing portals like Zillow and Trulia and other search sites. The third place that we're going to market your property online via is through search engines, otherwise known as SEO. And what that means is when people Google your property, it's going to be the first one that comes up because we're experts in both making sure the organic and paid advertising stays at the top. Last 2 places via are going to be on classified services and also on social media. Now, some people think, gosh, classified services, Craigslist, really? Just a year or so ago, we actually sold an airport on Craigslist. And just a little while before that, I did an open house. I posted that up while my team posted that open house on Craigslist. And I got a message from somebody saying, I can't make your open house on Saturday, but I'd love to come see the house. Can you meet me on Sunday? And I met them and wrote an offer on that kitchen counter on Sunday from Craigslist. So it's still working. And I don't know about you, Vija, but everybody I know is on social media. So we're going to make sure to showcase your property, Facebook, Instagram, and all other active social media places like that. I'm going to speed things up because I know we're short on time. We're going to make sure that we're going to reach buyers at every opportunity, Vija, not just online and internationally, but we're going to do all the traditional marketing as well, like our yard signs, our open houses and showings. We're going to make sure that we're networking regularly with the top agents. And even though Vija only 1% of buyers found their property through print advertising, we're going to make sure and go ahead and do that. We talked a little bit about our international marketing, but Vija, I don't know about you. I don't really care where the buyer comes from for your home as long as we get a buyer. And what we're seeing right now is billions of dollars spent from foreign buyers from all over the world. And you can see a graph here that's going to show you where they're coming from. Again, I don't care where they come from as long as we get you a buyer. The cool thing is we're getting people from all over the world. And with a home like yours in Kirkland, I'm really excited for it to hit the market and talk about all the buyers that come from all over. Taking a global approach doesn't stop there though, Vija. There's going to be 5 international buyers. We're going to make sure that we're going to crystal clear communicate with you through the software that I spoke about earlier. You're going to get all the feedback that we talk about. That's going to be ultra important. I know you said, Vija, that you're a straight shooter and you don't want me to be shy with any information. I'm going to ask your permission to be really just clear and upfront with all the feedback that comes through there. So if we're not getting an offer on your home, then we're going to know why. And we're going to change what we can. Continue to do any marketing feedback, and we're going to watch the market updates. As soon as we have your listing agreement signed, Vija, I can then dive into our active buyers database, and I can start calling around to see, just like with the home that you might be finding, who might be looking to buy a home just like yours. One of the other last things that sets us apart is our partnerships, Vija, and I absolutely love this because by having special financing through BKCO Mortgage, a mortgage company that we launched about a year ago, when you buy the home that you're looking to buy, if you're using financing, you're not going to have any origination fees, lender fees, underwriting fees, processing fees, and you're going to get a closing cost credit. In addition to that, the other partnerships that we have, Vija, that's going to be very beneficial is our mortgage companies, title, escrow, or concierge services. And if you need contractors to help get work done around your home, we've got that as well. Vija, one of the things I mentioned was the ability to negotiate and how I love to negotiate and how that's what I'm going to specialize in. Now, this is going to be really important too. You might know some friends that are thinking about just selling their home on their own. And I get this question all the time, Ryan, why would I put my home on the market with an agent when I can just sell my home on my own and get it sold? And you probably could. You probably could get your home sold. And my question would be, are you leaving money on the table? Because what we know is it's not just that purchase price to start. There's actually the pre-offer, the offer. Well, then you have the inspections and the appraisal and the personal property. And you have a few other places, Vija, where we're going to need to negotiate. And the most common thing that I see with a for sale by owner, they put their home on the market, they get that price they want, then they get beat up on inspection, and then the appraisal comes back low and they're taking $20,000, $30,000 less. But hey, they saved a percent on commission. Last, Vija, here's what we're going to do for you. We're going to make your listing shine. We're going to market your property to the top agents. We're going to make sure your property is heavily marketed online through the internet, as well as traditional marketing. Not stopping there, though, we're going to make sure it's marketed internationally. We'll be leveraging our buyer database. I'm going to communicate with you regularly and thoroughly, and I'm going to negotiate until we get it sold. I know you mentioned price, Vija, so that will be our next step, as we can take the tour of your home right now, walk through. I'll be taking notes as we go. Talk about the location of your neighborhood, when we might want to hit the market, condition of your home, competition of the other homes, and our terms. So, Vija, based off of everything I said, I know you haven't spoke with any other agents. The next steps that we would have would be simply to review our comparable properties after we take the tour, choose our price. We can complete our agreement, and we would pick our start date. And the last thing, Vija, is simply our promise to you. Our promise is simple, Vija. We know that you're going to be satisfied with our services just like Jalene was and the 5 or 6 other people that she referred to us. And if you aren't, Vija, you have a right to cancel that contract at any time. I like to make sure that people know that they can cancel that contract anytime. And the good thing is over the last 18 months, I haven't had a single person cancel on me. Every single property we've listed has sold. And every single person like you, Vija, that was a little worried about where they might go, not one of them ended up homeless. They all ended up with a home, and they all ended up with a home that they actually really love. They didn't have to compromise one bit. So we stand behind our ability to get you the price on your home, but also more importantly, find you a home to go to. And I'm going to go ahead and stop sharing my screen now. And I'd like to see what questions you have, Vija.
Yeah,
and if you don't have any questions, we can talk about our next steps.
I do have some questions. So I'm curious if you have any experience selling homes in my neighborhood or my area.
Absolutely, Via. And that would be one of the things that I would show you. And that would be one of the things that I would highly encourage you to look at is who is selling a lot of homes in your neighborhood. When we do the market pricing for your home, I'm going to specifically show you the homes that we've sold in your neighborhood. And I already know of a few of them. And you'll see pretty clearly that we've sold and have experience in your neighborhood and the other areas around the neighborhood.
And then I'm curious, what the market's actually doing. I'm hearing about all these multiple offers, and I'm just curious if my neighborhood, it seems like my neighborhood's going crazy, that everybody's selling on their first weekend with, 10 offers. And I've even seen some lines to get into open houses. And I'm curious, like, what you're seeing in my neighborhood.
I'm seeing exactly what you just said, Via. What we're seeing all over the market in my area is incredibly low inventory, which brings up your point of great, I would love to sell, but where do I go? And so what I'd like to do is talk with you a little bit more about some alternative options. People feel like they're really worried about contingent offers and those just won't get accepted. We just had one accepted last week, so contingent offers are certainly happening in this market. It's just a matter of doing it with the winning offer and making sure that you're doing it the right way. So that's one option. Another option that we brought up with a client just a couple of months ago that they hadn't thought of that their parents were sure happy about was they kept getting beat out on contingent offers. And so we just decided, well, what if we could put their home on the market and when it sells, they move in with their parents for a month or two. Their parents loved the idea of the grandkids moving in for a month or two. And what that allowed them to do was actually sell their home without a contingent offer. They were in no rush to sell. And they were able to sell that home for about $25,000 over the asking price. They moved in with their parents only for a month. They thought they were gonna have to do it for 3 months, but we found them a home. So they stayed with their parents for 1 month and they were able to move into the home that they wanted to move into. So my question, Via, and if people are taking notes, is would a temporary inconvenience be okay with you for a long-term financial gain? Meaning,
Yeah.
would
I
you
keep
be okay?
hearing about this thing called a rent back, Ryan, where we could maybe close on our home and stay in our home for a month or two afterwards. Do you have any experience with that?
I'm so glad you brought that up, Via. That was the next thing that I was going to bring up. You as the seller have a lot more control than I think the average seller really knows. And one of the things that we're doing, in fact, we just did this a couple of weeks ago, we were able to get 3 months of free rent back for a seller. And what that meant was they were able to close on their home, get the funds for their home, but actually stay in that home for 3 full months. Now, 3 months might be a little bit rare, but I think it's pretty common. 2 week, 2 to 4 weeks is a pretty common thing. So if a rent back for you is important, we can just include that in the listing terms.
Well, I love that idea and I would like that. And I know that my lender told me it has to be 59 days or less, Ryan, usually on most of my the buyers' loans that are going to buy with me. Also, Ryan, what is your experience with multiple offers? I just want to be sure we have an agent that's really experienced with those.
My experience with multiple offers on the listing side.
Yeah.
Every single home I put on the market has had multiple offers via. And so, what I do is I make sure this would be a good time for us to have a phone call and not a text message, and maybe even we meet in person. And I would present each one of those offers to you very thoroughly and clearly. And I would present each one of those pre-approval letters to you very clearly and thoroughly, as well as any letters that those buyers might provide as well, any love letters. Before I meet with you, Via, though, I'm going to call their listing agent and find out more about them. I'm going to call their lender and find out more about them. I'm going to look these people up online. I'm going to stalk these people and make sure that they are financially able to buy your home. Were there any other questions that you had in regards to multiple offers that I didn't answer that I can clarify?
Yeah, because I think the reason I asked that question is I will admit that because the market's so hot, we did talk about selling it ourselves. And I'm trying to justify paying, you 3% commission when it seems like there's lines around the block just to buy the homes in my neighborhood. And I'm just trying to understand, how if I should pay 3% really. I'm just being honest. I hope that's okay.
I'm so glad you asked, Vian. And like we said in the beginning, I know we're both straight shooters, so I wouldn't expect any different from you. That's a good question. And like I mentioned in that page on negotiating, I think that's just a piece of the puzzle. Negotiating is going to be one space where a seller can really get taken advantage of. You mentioned you'd sold a couple homes in the past, but have you ever sold a home actually on your own, Via? Okay. A lot of people think that it's a really easy thing to do. And oftentimes it is. You can just put the home on the market. Like I mentioned earlier, what I see, and I'd be happy to share some data with you and really let the data eliminate the drama on this. Via, what I see every day is that on average, a home that is sold by the owner will sell for 94 to 96% sale to list price, meaning they list that house for 700,000, but it sells 5 to 6% under the actual list price, okay? Mm-hmm. My list to sale price in your neighborhood, and I'm gonna make this up, but in my neighborhood up here is 99 to 102%. So I'm gonna put that data head to head. And Via, it sounds like you selling your home on your own and saving 3% commission, am I right to say that you want to net the most amount of money on the sale of your home? Would that be the reason you want to sell it on your own?
Yeah, for sure. And honestly, Ryan, we have friends and neighbors who are saying they want to buy our home off market. And so I'm kind of thinking maybe we do that. Is there any benefit to listing in a market like this?
Well, absolutely. You know, another benefit to selling to a neighbor is that it might be really easy for you, Via. So what's most important to you? Is an easy sale what's most important, or would getting the most amount of money be what's most important to you?
Getting the most amount of money.
You know, I always tell folks, Via, that if your neighbor's interested in your home, do you think other people might be as well?
Yeah, I do. I really think we could get multiple offers.
Yeah. I agree. You know, the inventory is so low that, in fact, just about every home is getting multiple offers. I think it's a really nice thing to do. In fact, my mom was talking about selling to her neighbor, and I finally had to tell her no. I said, "Mom, you're being too nice. You're going to leave about $50,000 on the table. Do you like your neighbor that much?" And often the answer is no. But sometimes people just want an easy sale, Via. And I'm here to make sure that I'm doing what's easiest and best for you. If you want an easy sale, and selling to your neighbor will get you where you want to go, let's talk about that. I can absolutely help with that. But it sounds like netting the most amount of money is your goal. And I imagine that putting your home on the market will do that. So should we go ahead and take care of the listing paperwork now and leave the date blank until we find you a home? Or did you have any other questions, Via?
I mean, are you negotiable on your commission?
I'm not. We charge 3%. Why do you ask?
Because I was wondering if I could get the listing for lower than 3%.
That's a great question. Standard commission, Via, is 3% on the list side. And the cool thing is, as the seller, you have an option to offer what you'd like to on the buy side. Again, standard is 3% on the buy side, but you do have the option to offer less. Would you like to offer the buyer's agent less than the full 3%, Via?
Maybe. I mean, can we get away with that right now? Should I do that? Do you advise that?
You absolutely can get away with it. You know, and I always like to think that realtors are ethical like I am. However, every once in a while, I have seen an agent that when they see a home on one street that has a 3% commission, if the one down the block has a 2% commission, are they going to skip it? And would they skip your home? I mean, I would hate to think that somebody might be unethical. So typically, Via, we do offer the same on both sides. And the way I break that down, that 3% commission on my side, Via, it's pretty simple and straightforward. You see, 1% is going to go to our brokerage. 1% is going to go to market your property. And we know we need to market your property online, offline, internationally. And 1% is going to go to me and my son, Bentley, and make sure that he's got some clothes on his back and that he's fed for school. Does that all break down for you in a way that is digestible?
Sure. Sure. Yeah, that makes great sense. Okay. I think we want to think about it.
Perfect. Absolutely, Via. I know this is a big decision. And a lot of times folks want to think about it. And usually when they say that, they have a question or two in their mind that I either didn't cover or I forgot to mention. I'm curious, Via, what is it that you want to think about?
We're going to interview a couple agents and just kind of want to get through that and pick the best one, I think.
I understand. I would do the same thing. And I know that Jalene had referred you to us, and I know she had bought and sold quite a few properties. I'm curious, Via, what else are you looking for in an agent that I forgot to mention today? Or what could I do to become your agent today so you didn't have to worry about calling any other agents?
You're right. I trust Jalene, and you came so highly recommended. And I think everything you said was great. So sure, we can go ahead and do it and just fill in the date later. Although I would really like to get a clear sense of price before we sign any paperwork. Just just before we make that decision.
Absolutely. I would want to do the same, Via. I think that coming up with a price that we both feel your home will sell at is a great plan. It sounds like the next step would be for me to just come over in person. Why don't we do this? I'll go ahead and email over the listing paperwork tonight. You can get started on that. And when would be a good time for me to meet with you in person? We can tour the home. We can dial on that price. I'll bring the listing agreement. We can just fill it in then. Is tomorrow good or would the next day be better?
Yeah, I think tomorrow would be good because that'll give us time to get the house ready because it's not ready yet. But then you could come through and we could talk and meet. And sure. And as long as the pricing is going to get us what we need to move, I think we're ready to go.
I think that sounds like a great plan, V. And then, of course, we're going to have to talk more about the home that you're looking for. And in between now and then, I'm going to go through that list that I told you about to see if I have any homes that might be a good fit that aren't on the market yet that I can let you know when we meet to physically tour your home.
Well, thank you so much, Ryan. And getting off role play, dude, you just let me throw you every objection I could think of, and you are a master. Bowing down to you. I threw it all out there. So great, great job. I think everybody appreciated that because we all sit there in that living room or at that dining room table and we know that's what they say, right? And we all know that they sometimes even push harder on that commission piece. So really, really, really good job. I know we had a bunch of questions and I really like to be interactive with our audience on these. This was a little bit of a different format and that we kind of pulled ourselves away from the questions. So, you know, I guess we're going a little longer, but it's important to me that we do address some of them because I'm seeing some commonalities as I skim them, Ryan. One of them is, I thought of it myself, and that is 555. It is hard to find 555 right now. So, you know, what are you saying in that space when there's literally not five active, five pending, and five sold? Necessarily.
Absolutely. It's very rare that you're going to find five actives, right? Or you probably find 5 to 10 solds, depending on where you are.
Sure.
So you've got to do your best and you can let that be your leverage and say, Via, you know, I went to do that 555 and I found one home that's comparable to yours. It looks like the market is speaking to us and there's no other homes available. So I'm looking at the price and I'm looking at the amount of actives. There's only one. You might have to go a little bit farther back on your solds and looking into your pendings. Now that's actually, you have to be careful though, because I priced a home the other day and the price on it from the comparables from November and just this last two weeks of closing are very different. Mm-hmm. So I think you have to do your best you got to work with what you got.
Mm-hmm. And you just tell the seller that you're just pretty transparent about it.
Yeah. I say, this is how we do it when it's an option.
That's what I do too. I'm super transparent. And like, you know, we all have the same data and it's a trending price line. It's going up and every single pending, you know, as they close, it's just moving the bar up and, you know, yeah. If you were an individual agent competing against yourself, competing against a team, you know, what would you do? Because a lot of this was a team presentation. What would you do to compete against yourself?
I can tell you what people do to compete against me. They say things like, well, you know, Ryan is just, you're going to get passed off to Ryan. You're never going to hear from Ben. You know, they're a pyramid. So an individual agent would probably leverage something like that. They would say, well, you know, they're a massive team. They're so big, they can't manage things. So you should work with me as an individual agent because I can give you much better service. So, you know, I don't know. Can they? I don't know because they're so busy trying to manage everything. If I was competing against me, I would. That's the lane I would take. I would say something like, "Look, I do all of this on my own because you really can't compete against our team." I'd say I do this all on my own, and you're gonna have 100% presence with me, and I'm gonna be 100% here with you. And the reason I choose to be an individual is because I like to do things all on my own. That's what I would do. Yeah.
Ryan Greigg, thank you so much. And to all of our viewers today, thank you. We are here, like I said, every Wednesday at noon. Throughout the year, I'm going to bring different types of agents on to do this role play. So we'll have individual agents. Don't you worry. I know today was a big team one. We'll have individual agents. We're going to have luxury agents. We're going to do buyer consults. And we're going to, you know, we're just going to cover the gamut because I think it's really useful to get a highly successful agent in role play mode and just start rolling the objections out, just like we all experience them, rather than teach it, you know, from the podium. So So we really appreciate you, Ryan. And next week, you guys, we have Laura Gelat and her team from Lebanon, Oregon, on how to thrive with a database-driven team through, quarantine and COVID and post-COVID. And it's going to be so useful. Every time I've seen Laura Gelat present with her team, every single time, I've gotten at least two or three things that I've implemented immediately. And it's almost 100% database-driven. So that's next week. And stick with us. We're here every week. So thank you again, Ryan. We appreciate you and have a great week, everybody.
Absolutely. My pleasure, Via. Thank you for having me. Have a great week, everyone.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.